a blessed evening to this community, St. Paul's. And we are here, Antigua and Barbuda, the true little party, to let you know that we are fed up with number and we cannot trust the one called Chekwi. I am saying to you tonight that this community has been forgotten. Look around. Look around, you can see the deplorable conditions of this recreation facility right here. Look around you on the street lights around here. Look around at the pipe facility down here where there's garbage and everything surrounding the water area. Look around the community. They have left you high and dry. And we are saying tonight that we are here to give you that hope. I hope that there will be a brighter tomorrow. I hope that there will be prosperity. I hope that you will have jobs and opportunities to put your kids to school. I'm saying to you tonight that they have forgotten you. And I am saying tonight that we are here to give you issues and to give you solutions to the problems that face this community. We and the LPLUPP for the past months have been attacking each other on the radio, degrading our country. We are here to give you positive reasoning, not to push anything down your throat, but to give you information that you can make a well and informed decision on election day. Yes. What am I saying? I'm saying to you, they have left you behind. I'm saying to you, it's time for you to rise up. Rise up with a political party who will fight for your issues, who will table your cause in parliament. I am saying to you, those of you out here talking about the sticking behind the ALP, supporting Chet, who is Chet? Does anyone around here know where Chet Green lives? Chet Green lives down in Broad Lodge, 10 miles away. And I'm saying to you, after the election, you won't see Chet Green. You will not see him. It's crazy that this man ran a primary against Namba in 1999. And finally, the fight for power, he switched the Antigua Labour Party. And not only switched the Labour Party, but we had a candidate here by the name of Franklin George, who had the backbone of the Antigua Labour Party. And he was pushed out and fought against by Chet Green. And you people of this community, you got up and you fought against Chet Green and supported Wrigley because you thought what would happen was wrong. And today, the same Chet Green is here asking you to support Labour. You ever hear Chet Green saying Labour Party comments? I want you to understand what is happening. Is that there's a bunch of you people who check candidates has found themselves in the Antigua Labour Party. They have swindled themselves into the Antigua Labour Party. I'm talking people like Chet Green, who ran a primary against Namba. I'm talking about Dean Joyless, who ran a primary against Jackie Quinn. I'm talking about Colin James, who was appointed to the Commission of Electoral Boundaries. And because he was fired by Baldwin Spencer, he was then placed on the Antigua Labour Party ticket. This is what's happening in our country. And what has been happening to our people of Antigua is that these two political parties has divided us into tribes. Tribes! That it doesn't matter who runs on which side you vote with them because they support the party. Let me say to you tonight, that's old-time mockery. We are a people who are educated. We are people who are conscious of what's happening. And we need to vote and send the true message to these two parties. That we will not be fooled anymore. What am I saying? I'm saying to you people who are stuck on the blue chain. And those of you who are stuck with the big red machine. Both parties are coming down. And we are saying that we intend to continue to build this institution to take this country. We are going to table your issues. But let me say to you tonight that we have plans. We have plans. And some of the plans that we have is to develop these recreational facilities. We are planning to put a you will have produced to export to different parts of the island. We are saying that English harbour farmers has a vibrant yacht economy over there. And for decades I've seen young men travelling to St. John's to buy groceries, to buy provisions. And we have the land here that can make these provisions. I'm saying to you, it's time for us to get in tune with what's happening. I can't believe that the people of this community that doesn't have a vehicle have to pay the ride to the tank. This is unacceptable! And you people out here, whether behind the mansion, it's shame on you people. We are saying we are going to put a bus in place. And this bus route will be subsidized by the government so you can have transportation in and out of this community. I am saying to you tonight, plans to educate you, plans to promote this community. And you need to give us that chance. You need to give me this opportunity. You have given the United Progressive Party 10 years and plus. The Antigua Labour Party 28 years. How can we go backwards? How can we go backwards? Yet still we cannot condone the present party power. So what am I saying? I'm saying it's time for us to move on. Move on for a new party. Move on to new blood, fresh blood. And I'm saying to you tonight, I am saying to you tonight that we are ready to take the government. And I am saying we will fight and we will continue to fight. And we are saying no retreat, no surrender. Yes. I'm saying to you tonight, the Antigua Two-Labour Party has programs to uplift this community. And one of the things I myself would like to undertake in this community is a housing project to assist the people of this community who cannot afford to build a house, that we can expect that you will help develop this whole community of yourself. I am saying to you tonight that we have been left behind. Up to this day, Namba Norchet has been here to have a meeting because they don't think that your vote is significant to make a difference.
Yes.
Have you seen any posters up here? Have you seen this guy have a political meeting up here? Not one of them. I am saying to you, down with Chet, down with Namba, up with the Antigua Two-Labour Party, and that's Gregory Attill, that's me. And let me say to you tonight, some of you who don't know me, I will say my name again, Gregory Attill.
Yes.
And I am from the village of English Harbour. And my parents are from the Bota. And you know who I am. And let me say to you, some of you look around and say, oh, you're driving a taxi. Let me say to you, I have been to school and I have a captaincy license. And for years, I have been delivering boats from Antigua to England, from Antigua to the United States. And when we are on the boat, we say, no God, no glory. So it's not that you're having somebody who doesn't understand what is happening. We know what is happening. And today, I manage the Antiguan National Taxi Association. We have the vice president who deals with issues that are affecting our drivers. This is what I do. Fight for people's rights. And I'm saying to you that Chet is the greatest deceiver. You should make a movie with him. The greatest deceiver. And don't talk about Namba. We all know Namba is the actor. We already know. So we need not spend time on Namba. Namba lost his way. And no way he'll be back. It's time to send Namba on a pension scheme. It's time for you to tell Namba he wasted your votes. It's time for you to tell Namba he will be rejected at the polls. The only thing you hear is good morning, good morning, good morning. When is he gonna come and tell you he has a job for you? When is he gonna come and let you know that there is hope? Nothing at all from Namba. Nothing at all. And yet still, some of you in this community are still talking about Namba just because one or two of you are working for Namba. It's all for one and one for all. Yeah. And when you have people in the community who are suffering, we all are brothers and sisters. And you have the right to go to them and let them know these people need employment. These people need to be lifted up. That's what our Antigua is all about. But we've lost our way. Because these two political parties have been winding up our people. Let me say to you, it's just last week, some members of the United Progressive Party put a beating on the guys that support the Antigua Party. Just last week. So while the politicians are gearing you up to fight each other, they are sitting back and allowing you to do the dirty work. That's what's happening. You ever hear any politician about jail? Not yet. And this is what you and the people need to understand. That when you are out here fighting, turning your back against your neighbor because you support a different party, the politicians out here drinking rum and wine together. So we as the Antiguan people have to get away from this kind of clan mentality and live with our brothers and sisters as one people. A country which is divided will fall and will not prosper. I'm saying to you tonight, what is your plan? I'm saying to you tonight, where would your vote go? But let me say, this election is not about voting between two colors or two individuals. This election is about voting for the direction you want to take your country. It's either prosperity or downwards. And I'm saying to you, your decision should be upwards. Your decision should be governmental. Let me say to you, for years I've fought, for years, my parents has fought for the Antigua Labour Party. And my cousin, all the Ralphs in these areas are my cousins. This is the community that my grandfather came from. My grandfather, Lauriston Howell, who is first cousin to the Ralphs in this area. And our family has fought with the Antigua Labour Party. And we have been left behind. And I want to look around tonight. And what I want you to do is whenever these three political parties are having meetings, I want you to look around and look around and see if you see any Syrians or Chinese. It's all black picky-head people around us. And what happened? After the election, they man sue and shows all of them. They're up in the office. Yes. Collecting what we the people should be collecting. If you do research on Antigua, you would realize that 91.2% of the people of Antigua are black people. So how can we have 9.8.8% dictating our country and running our country? Hadi was supporting the Antigua Labour Party. And when he realized the Antigua Labour Party was losing their government, he switched to the United Progressive Party. And now he believes the United Progressive Party will be losing government. He's in a limbo. Financing the two political parties. So whichever direction the government goes, they're there. And we, the people, are being left behind. We have been left behind. We have to understand as a people that it's time for us to make informed decisions. You have learned one plan from Namba. You have learned one plan from Chet Green. Look at the state of the police station in Liberta. Look at the state of the clinic in Cops Cross, where our clinic in Cops Cross have been closed over 3 years because of rat infestation. And up to this day, 10 years, we can't get the clinic. Namba promised the clinic when he got into office. Up to this day, we don't have a clinic. Now, I will believe a yachting industry, which is the breadbasket of St. Paul's, having a state-of-the-art clinic there, where we could have services done to the yacht men who will contribute to our tax scheme. That is the plan. My plan is to get English Harbour and Falmouth Harbour as a duty-free port. As a duty-free port, which will increase yacht arrival. Days and months you see yachts leaving Antigua going to St. Martin for provisioning and to buying stocks. Just because the tax scheme is high here. And water, We are saying that when we have a duty report, the government will not have a direct tax, but the indirect tax, with the people are spending money and the businesses in the area, will create a ripple effect in the Indian industry. And that's where you, the people, have power and money to spend. Then the tax going directly into the government, and then they're wasting our resource. I am saying we need to put a fun warehouse out in English Harbour. So you people in this area, when Christmas comes, or whenever you decide to do your shopping in St. Martin or Puerto Rico, you don't have to travel to St. John's to Port Lauderdale. You could go to English Harbour, where you can get your goods right there. A brand warehouse is where all the goods for people living in the St. Paul's area will be transferred from St. John's to this area in English Harbour. And what will this do? It will increase personnel, job opportunities for officers, for security, for pillars. This is what we plan to do, to create infrastructure, to create jobs for you, the people. That is what we have to do. Get rid of number, get rid of jet. Let me say to you, my brothers and sisters, it's real plans we have. This is not no phony thing. These are simple projects that can be achievable. I am not going to give you no pie in no sky, because I am not here to fool you. I am here to give you what our plans are. I am here to inform and to give you ideas as that you can have an informed decision. And at the end of the day, you will come out and support Gregory Attell on election day. I'm saying to you today, look around at the kids in this community. Months driving up here, the kids right on here playing Nintendo, playing games, because there's not no proper facilities here. When we were small, we played a lot of football, a lot of cricket. Look around and see, and you see what happened. Look at the millions of dollars in Larry Perkins' party spend and fencing all the playing field of Orlando Antigua. But yes, so what happened here? What happened here? This community has been left behind. When I told a guy a couple days ago that I'm going up New Village to have a meeting, you know what he said? Where you going up there for? Where you going up there for? And I decided to come up here so you can have a first-hand opportunity to hear. Some of you looking at yourself, smiling, come on, let me tell you something. I have plans. And some of you who are here, who are still with the mindset that there's only two parties, and we should back off. You know what you're saying to your kids? You know what you're saying to your son? That you cannot go into politics unless you support these two guys.
Yes.
That's what you're telling your kids.
Yes, that's what I want to tell
you. You must always give people the chance. You cannot bring down your own people.
I'm telling you.
Your own people. And you know number lives. Nobody knows what number lives. Number is a rolling stone. I am from the community. Most of you here know me. What you see, what you get. I'm not no fancy guy. I am here to make a point to let you know you waste the time supporting these two parties. And it's time for you to make a change. And a positive change. How can you fail? You can't fail when you're here to another party. You can't fail because you've given the other two parties an opportunity and they failed you. They failed you miserably. And this is what's happening. I'm saying to you, the people who are listening, the people inside of your house, because I know you can hear me, rise up. Rise up and join the fight. The fight for Antigua. The fight for this community. I'm saying to you, no retreat, no surrender. And we will push forward. I'm saying to you tonight, you all know me. I've been around the communities a lot.
Yes.
You know me. For years, I've been a president of the Antigua Youth Sailing Club, teaching kids from the St. Paul's community how to sail. That's my job. And it's not a paid job. That's what I do to give back to the community. That's what I do. For years. So that I can educate the young people of this community. So when the yachts are out there, you people of this community can go out and get a job. But let me say to you tonight, my plan is to also put an industrial park in St. Paul's. So we the people out here can go and get a hands-on approach of life. And for those people who are academically inclined, we are saying you won't be left behind. We're not going to leave you on the side to smoke this. We're not leaving you on the side and kicking you out of the community. We are saying that you are part of the community. And we want to assist in the development of our country.
Yes.
What am I saying tonight? I'm saying tonight that we decided to have a political meeting up here tonight. And we announced it last week. And Chet Green decided now to have a party down the road. Think he could distract the meeting up here. Let me say to you tonight, you need to let Chet Green and the Antigua party know that they cannot bribe you. This mentality of you begging and then giving you handouts, it's far-fetched. And I'm saying to you, we are here to empower you, so you don't have to be going begging after a politician. We are saying, we don't have no $500 to give you, your t-shirt for your vote. We are saying you should vote and vote on your conscience. That is what I'm saying. $500 can't be a pay life bill. Can't be a pay life bill. And when you don't vote for Chetney, look and smile and laugh after you. And when they finish wasting to you, foul.
Yes.
That's what I have to understand.
To read
look what happened with Namba. After Namba lost the Willie election the last time. Nobody see Namba. Nobody see Namba. Namba up with the United States with Spanish chicks alive. That's what Namba doing. That is what Namba doing with Spanish chicks all over the country. Traveling all over to Suriname with 80 something people. And people here can't find work to do. And let me say to you tonight. Let me say to you tonight. If you can imagine the amount of money spent on this plastic wrapping on telephone poles. And you people are here unemployed. While millions and millions of dollars have been spent on these lampposts. And it's amazing to see how dumb we Antiguans can be. That we're running behind these political parties, spending millions on the street, and the government is finished with nothing to eat. How dumb can that be? Save your energy, stop wrong. Because they're not telling you nothing to edify you. They're not telling you anything to educate you. The only thing that the other party said, time of borrowing, time of borrowing. Borrowing said, pull away the gears, pull away the gears. This kind of metric can't work. Y'all feel more educated than that. So you see what is happening? They're having us like a union. Up and down, up and down. And the people, I'm surprised when I see people running out there after Chet. Who is Chet? So I want to ask the people tonight, who's sticking behind Chet? If we replace Chet and put Bauer and Spencer out here to run a Labour Party ticket, would you vote for him? If we put Higher Lovell today on the Labour Party ticket out here, would you vote for him? And I know all of you are saying no. But what is the difference with Chet? For years, Chet and his family have been supporting the United Progressive Party. And because of power, he's changed the other side. So this is how we have to look at it. But let me give you a scenario. Let me give you a scenario. Do you believe that if both parties have almost seats, the 17 seats, one for Barbuda, 16 for Antigua, do you think if the Antigua Labour Party wins 8 and the United Progressive Party wins 8 and the party and the United Progressive Party decides to give Chet Green the Prime Minister, do you think he will save Labour? The answer is no. That he has no backbone of Labour. You people of this community, stop supporting Chet. Chet is just a poor, hungry individual. That's who he is. That is what I'm saying to you tonight. I don't have to touch Namba Kanama in the West. Because some of you, when you hear me talking against Chet, you're saying you're supporting UPP. I don't support UPP. I'm being honest to you, the people of this community. Look at some of you coming home with your red. Some of you coming home. Just tonight, I have to give two young ladies a ride out the corner. I have a meeting here, and I'm giving two young ladies a ride to Chet meeting.
Chet party.
Chet party. That's how I am. The two ladies come in and ask for a ride, I give them a ride. This is what I'm saying to you. they have you like flies. Yet you want to be begging right to go to the party, go to the meeting. While we the Antigua School of Party is right here at your doorstep. Right here. But I'm saying to you before I leave, I'm saying to you, give the Antigua School of Party an opportunity to run this country. We're only 5 members, but we will make a difference. And we will continue to build this institution so that you, the people, can have a hope. I hope that one day there will be prosperity. I hope one day that our people will move forward in life. I hope that one day our people will have a level playing field. And I say to you tonight, Antigua True Labour Party, Gregory Atil, St. Paul. Thank you.
You're not alone. Live, I'll be right there for you. You're not alone. Live, I'll be right there for you.